They can be dusty, slimy, and downright disgusting with a stench that's unmistakable. They can make your food inedible, your basement unlivable, but they might also save your life. We're talking about everything you ever needed to know about mold. Maybe some stuff you didn't need to know, too.
Hey, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Floralogic. Let's get down and dirty with funky fungi called mold. The first festering question is, how the heck is mold a fungus? Some fungi grow into mushrooms, while others are single-celled microfungi like yeasts. In the case of molds, these fungi are multicellular microorganisms, so they're more closely related to portobellos, but just very, very tiny and simple.
Molds are made up of mycelium and fruiting bodies of certain fungi. Mycelium are the root-like structures of fungus that are made up of thread-like hyphae. The fruiting body is a structure that's specialized in producing spores for reproduction.
They come in almost every color: blue, white, red, orange, yellow, pink, brown, green, and even the dreaded black.
True to their fungus roots, if you zoom in, molds look like teeny tiny little microscopic mushrooms. Zoom back out, and you'll recognize the hyphae from the fuzzy appearance of that moldy orange on your counter, and the spores from the cloud that comes off of it when you toss it in the compost bin.
The spores that mold releases really get around. They can travel a number of ways: by air, water, or carried by insects and animals. That's why mold can be found pretty much anywhere on the planet, both indoors and outdoors.
Once the spores find an ideal environment, like moist, shady areas, they'll set up shop and start multiplying. Most molds prefer decomposing materials. For this reason, molds are an extremely important part of nature's recycling process, breaking down plant and animal matter so those resources can be used elsewhere.
But mold doesn't discriminate, as long as the conditions are right. It can grow pretty much anywhere with moisture, oxygen, and some organic material to consume.
The usual types of mold that are found inside are from the genera Cladosporium, Aspergillus, Alternaria, and Penicillium, to name a few.
They can be good, neutral, or evil in terms of their effects on humans and human endeavors. Let's break down these four genera.
Cladosporium, containing over 700 species that we know about, are among the most common species of mold in the world. They're almost completely harmless to humans, though some can cause allergies and asthma. They usually grow on rotting organic material, but can grow inside your refrigerator, causing food spoilage and discoloration.
Cladosporium molds often present themselves as brown, green, or even black. But this isn't the toxic black mold you're thinking about. We'll get to that one in a minute.
On the helpful side of the mold spectrum, we have the species of the Penicillium genus. These molds are responsible for some of the most popular soft and stinky cheeses, like brie, camembert, gorgonzola, and roquefort.
The genus name also gives away the fact that life-saving penicillin is derived from one species, Penicillium chrysogenum, which was previously known as Penicillium notatum.
Today, penicillin is a staple antibiotic, but before it was discovered by accident in 1928, people died regularly from all kinds of basic infections. Penicillin works by targeting bacterial cell walls. It disables an enzyme needed to strengthen the walls. The bacteria keeps growing, but without a sturdy wall to support it, eventually swells up, ruptures, and dies.
Among Alternaria mold species are some major plant pathogens that have the power to decimate entire crops with black rot.
If you've ever seen a squishy brown spot on an apple, an Alternaria species is probably to blame. And yes, one bad apple will certainly spoil the whole bunch, at least when it comes to Alternaria mold, which spreads quickly from fruit to fruit.
The greatly feared species known as black mold is Stachybotrys chartarum, and it's had a bit of a PR problem. This mold has been vilified as toxic, but it turns out it's not actually as deadly as it's made out to be.
Black mold loves cellulose, aka fibers from plants, so it makes itself cozy in paper, wood, and drywall. Sure, it'll cause sneezing, coughing, congestion, and eye irritation, and make asthma symptoms worse, but this species isn't actually any more dangerous than other types of mold. And it probably won't kill you.
When it comes to Aspergillus molds, some can be helpful and some can be extremely harmful. One species causes the disease aspergillosis, which can cause mild to severe illness in people with weakened immune systems.
Other species, namely the koji molds, have been used in East Asia for thousands of years in fermentation to create products like soy sauce and sake. Yet other species, Aspergillus flavus and Aspergillus parasiticus, which grow on crops in warm and humid regions of the world, produce dangerous toxic chemicals known as aflatoxins.
Aflatoxins can make people and animals very ill. They're the best known and most researched fungal toxin, and are known to cause nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and convulsions if ingested. Chronic exposure causes liver damage and cancer.
In fact, aflatoxins are considered to be one of the most carcinogenic substances in the world. These aflatoxins come from molds that grow mostly on crops like corn, rice, millet, wheat, peanuts, cottonseed, and tree nuts. To reduce your risk of exposure, it makes sense to buy products from major commercial producers and to ditch any nuts that seem shriveled, moldy, or discolored.
One of the most burning questions about mold is it safe to just cut the moldy part off your food and eat the rest? The simple answer is no, not really.
By the time the mold is visible on the surface, it means that it's likely already been infested throughout with the mold's invisible root-like mycelium. In the case of dangerous molds, that means that mycotoxins may be present even if the part you're eating looks okay to the naked eye.
If you do accidentally ingest something moldy, you don't have to panic though. You're probably just going to be fine. Just monitor yourself for the rest of the day, and if you experience any severe symptoms, like shortness of breath or a fever, seek medical attention right away. From trying to kill you to being used to make life-saving medicine, molds are an unending source of intrigue. With an estimated 300,000 species worldwide, we may never fully comprehend everything molds are capable of. What we do know for sure is that mold is always going to spoil your lunch. So, what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments below and be sure to subscribe for new episodes every single week. Thanks for watching. See ya.
Hey everyone, we have exciting news. We're thrilled to announce the release of Animalogic's very first book, Strange Creatures. This book dives into the most incredible animals we've ever featured on the show, with each chapter packed with my illustrations and stunning full-color images. It's a fun and engaging way to learn about the animal kingdom, and a perfect tool to spark kids' interest in science. Each chapter breaks down an animal's biology, behavior, and all the coolest facts you need to know about these fascinating creatures. Animalogic Strange Creatures is a must-have addition to your own library, or the perfect gift for an animal lover this upcoming holiday season. Click the link in the description to check it out, and if you can, order a copy. It would mean the world. Thank you so much, and I hope that you love the book.